Do you feel safe? Aren't you afraid? These are the questions that I get when I tell my story. And I love telling my story. I will tell it to anyone who will listen. It's a story of love and adventure and renewal and transformation of mind, body, and soul. So when I tell all these details and I hear, "Do you feel safe?" I want to scream and say, "Really? Were you not just listening to me?" I can tell you, when I had cancer and had a port in my chest and was bald and skin and bones and wanted to die, then maybe I didn't feel safe. When I was trying to uncouple from a dangerous and unhealthy relationship with a man that I loved and was terrified of, then maybe I didn't feel safe. Or when I had given up my identity and sold my soul for the lifestyle I was in and didn't know how to ask for help, maybe then I didn't feel safe. But this story, this wonderful story of big love, well, you decide. It goes something like this. So 4 years ago, the doctors gave me the okay to travel again after my cancer. And I wanted to go someplace I had never been before. It was Turkey or India. Well, it was August, so I wasn't going to India. I decided Turkey. I brought my best friend with me. She's 10 years younger, had kind of given up on love, was trying to decide if she should just leave everything and go to Paris for this job. But then she said, "I don't want to go to Turkey. Let's go to Barcelona. Let's get a house on the beach and make out with surfers." I was like, okay, that sounds like a lot of fun, but I need to go to Turkey. I can't explain why. It's in my soul. I feel it, and it has to do with big love. Well, that's all I needed to say. Those were the buzzwords she was in. We land in Turkey, walk into our hotel, we see the Bosphorus in front of us, the body of water that separates Asia from Europe. I'm hooked. But then I get sick again. I spend 2 days in the hotel, can't move. I told her this could happen from my treatment. She's a good sport, but on the third day decides to call one of the names on the list of the many names we were given when we went on our trip, and she's gonna go meet somebody for a drink that night. Well, thinking it's probably not the best idea to let her go alone in a city we don't know, where we don't speak the language, and it's nighttime to meet a man we don't know, I rallied, I went with her. We get down there, she goes to make a phone call, I go to the restaurant to find him. I'm walking through the tables, and I see this beautiful man who looks kind of like Benicio del Toro walk towards me. I'm like, wow. Well, he's on the phone, he doesn't see me, I'm invisible. I look to see what he's seeing. And he's seeing my friend with her hair blowing in the wind, on the phone, smoking a cigarette. They turn, their eyes meet. I watch for the very first time. Fireworks, love at first sight. Well, that's their story. But it's a good one, and it is about love, big love. They do distance, they get engaged, they get married. I find myself coming back to Turkey a year later for the wedding. Late at night, I land in Bodrum, this beautiful little village in the Aegean. No idea where I am. I wake up in the morning, and I see the sun rising out of the Aegean, the Greek islands in the background, and I feel like I'm home. I see the purple-blue waters. I feel it in my soul, like I've lived there before, and I can't explain why. I just knew that I belonged there. It was a magical week. I loved it. I came back to Washington, D.C., but I felt like part of me was still there, and I had to figure out a way to go back. So I did. I rebelled against what all my friends said, what all my family said, what everybody said. I trusted my heart. I sold my house, quit my job, bought a one-way ticket, and went right back to Turkey. Had 3 job interviews, got an offer, got a house. And then it's a little village house. I wake up every morning to chickens. I don't have air conditioning, but I look at the sea. And I feel love and happiness like I've never felt before. I feel connected to my soul. I feel love. I feel renewed. I feel transformed. I feel inspired. So when people say at the end of this story, "Do you feel safe?" I know what they're talking about. They're talking about the politics of the Middle East, the politics of Turkey. And what I can say is the people are wonderful and beautiful and hospitable, and I'm so happy when I'm there. But to answer it correctly, I'll quote the Sufi poet Rumi, which is very fitting. "I am not this hair, I am not this skin, I am the soul that lives within. And for the first time in my life, I realized I did find big love. I found love within myself, self-love, And so, yes, I felt safe. Thank you.